बड़े प्यार से उसे पकड़ा गया, बड़े कामली उसने कहा कि यहाँ बस हिंदुओं की चलेगी, दीज आर हिज वर्ड्स, सिर्फ हिंदुओं की चलेगी। इतनी ही आइडियोलॉजी थी तब भी 1948 में जब गांधी को गोली मारी थी, कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट एक ही जजमेंट में ये भी कहता है कि बाबरी मस्जिद का टूटना अनलॉफुल था, और फिर उसी जजमेंट में उन्हीं लोगों को रिवॉर्ड भी करता है जिन्होंने मस्जिद तोड़ी थी। A second shooter has been apprehended in Shaheen Bagh like an hour ago, and बड़े प्यार से उसे पकड़ा गया, बड़े कामली उसने कहा कि यहाँ बस हिंदुओं की चलेगी, these are his words, सिर्फ हिंदुओं की चलेगी। और इतना ही है ये सब जो हो रहा है, उसके पीछे कोई बहुत महान आइडियोलॉजी नहीं है। इतनी ही आइडियोलॉजी थी तब भी 1948 में जब गांधी को गोली मारी थी कि सिर्फ हिंदुओं की चलेगी। इस सारे नफरत के पीछे एक बहुत ही तंग दिल वाली मनमानी है, दैट्स ऑल इट इज। एंड आई थिंक दैट वी हैव नाउ रीच्ड अ प्लेस वेयर वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट दैट द फियर दैट वी हैड कि क्या हो जाएगा, क्या हो जाएगा, क्या हो जाएगा, वो हो चुका है। हम एक ऐसे देश में हैं जहां हमारे देश के सुप्रीम कोर्ट एक ही जजमेंट में ये भी कहता है कि बाबरी मस्जिद का टूटना अनलॉफुल था, और फिर उसी जजमेंट में उन्हीं लोगों को रिवॉर्ड भी करता है जिन्होंने मस्जिद तोड़ी थी।
बहुत
तो आ चुका है, जो भी हमें डर था, जो भी वो अनस्पीकेबल फियर था, वो है। वी आर लिविंग इट नाउ, वी आर एट दैट मोमेंट जहां पे यूनिफॉर्म पर्सनल जो हमारे संविधान पे हाथ रख के शपथ लेते हैं, वो अनआर्म्ड मुसलमानों पे वार करते हैं, उनकी प्रॉपर्टीज डिस्ट्रॉय करते हैं, और गालियां देते हैं, घरों में घुसते हैं सिर्फ क्योंकि वो आई डोंट नो नॉनवेज खाते हैं, लाइक आई डोंट इवन नो व्हाट द रीजन इज। एंड देयरफॉर बिकॉज वी आर इन दैट प्लेस, एंड आई एम सॉरी मे बी आई एम नॉट आंसरिंग द क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो बिकॉज आई डिडंट हियर इट, बट आई थिंक दैट इट बिकम्स एब्सोल्युटली इंपेरेटिव to ask ourselves, what do we do? What do we do in a society when we are more bothered by the fact that a stand-up comic heckled someone in a flight than we are bothered by the fact that people are roam around with guns and shoot? What do we do with this concept of civilization that doesn't consider murder wrong but considers impoliteness to be a crime? What do we do with that concept of civilization? What do we do when the people who are supposed to enforce law and order do not believe in the law themselves? That is the question to ask ourselves. We are ruled by a government that does not believe in our constitution. We are ruled by police forces that do not believe in the constitution. It seems we are now in a situation where our courts are not sure whether they believe in the constitution or not. I think we should see Kunal Kamra's act as an act of resistance. That was an act of protest. It doesn't have to be polite. He's not up against one man, and Arnab Goswami's privacy is not what is at stake in this country. What is at stake is the existence of crores of people. What is at stake is the very nature of our country. What is at stake, and that we are losing very rapidly, is the spirit of our constitution. So, frankly, invade privacy. I mean, don't break a law. But the next time we see someone like that on a flight, a person in power, a person who's abused their power, a person who has lied to the people of this country every single day, who has willfully abused his power and spread hate, let's confront them. Let us confront Arnab Goswami every single time we see him. Let us confront every single officer or person who holds a position of authority in this government. Let's confront every single minister of this government and every single person who is an ally to this government, wherever we find them. Let's do it. Today it was beautiful, you know, and resistance can take many forms. We are so creative. I mean, I think the most amazing thing, because this is a panel about artists, the most amazing thing that I've seen in these protests is the kind of creativity that we have seen and the kind of art that we have seen be created at this time. And I think we can use all of that. I'm sure you all saw it on social media, but there was this one young woman who boarded an IndiGo flight wearing a placard that said, "IndiGo Airlines, I'm ashamed of you and I support Kunal Kamra, and read the letter your captain wrote." What an amazing act of resistance. There was another picture that I saw on social media today where someone was traveling by Air India, and they've written on the seat, you know, that cover that they have on the seat, they've written on that, "Air India, I support Kunal Kamra, and you shouldn't have done whatever." Like, that is an act of resistance. This is the kind of resistance we must find at every step, because I mean, of course, yes, we are scared. We are all scared, and we all have something to lose. But yet, we can find ways that are smart. We can find ways that are ingenious to keep this resistance alive. Every act of protest does not have to have thousands of us sitting at Gateway of India or at Mumbai Bagh or anywhere. Those are important as well, and they must happen, and kudos to those people. They have given us a reason to hope. But I'm just saying that the fight can take many forms, because it's a fight that is not going to end soon. It's a fight that is long, it's a fight that will continue, and it is a fight that must be fought at every single step and at every level we find, and in every nook and cranny that we can get into. And yeah, that's it. Resist. Let's resist. We this is a battle, and we must be happy for that battle. Thank you.
If you like our channel, please subscribe, and to get notifications about news, please click the bell icon.